Alright guys, welcome back to Our World Outdoors. I'm Tony, and today we're going to be doing the one-year review on the Merrell Moab 2, the non-waterproof version. Okay, as you can see, I didn't clean these. I want you guys to see an honest view of what I've done to these things. So, let's start from the beginning. A year ago, which actually is just slightly under a year actually, I bought these. I had been running a cheaper shoe for a while, and my wife finally got on my case and said, go get something nice. So I picked these up and I literally pulled them on my feet. Said they felt good, had plenty of toe room for my feet swell. It was half size bigger than what I normally wear. And we went to Burr Oak State Park in Ohio and did their Lakeshore Trail. Lakeview Trail, whatever you want to call it. It's 22.5 miles. We day hiked it. That's no break-in period, no nothing. And I came home and I had one very small blister, and it was just because of the socks I had on. These shoes performed out of the box awesome. I mean, there's nothing wrong with grabbing these and going. So, fast forward, if you watch our channel, you know we put the miles down. We don't play around. We did, I don't know, about 500 or 600 miles I did on these shoes. And then my wife got me into the Keen Targi 3. And they just felt so good on my feet. They're waterproof. They just supported my ankles well. I have surgically repaired ankles, so obviously these are good for strengthening, but they're not good for support when I'm in rocky areas. And I had to wear real heavy ankle braces with these when I was going to rough areas, whereas with my Keens I can wear lightweight ones. But anyways, at that point these kind of got retired from hiking, you know, 500-600 miles. So what I did was, if you get online, Merrell is now full production bore selling their own replacement insoles, exact fit insoles. So you grab these, they're about, I want to say for these, I think they were $12. These are a little bit better ones than the stock ones. But yeah, $12, they fit exactly how the shoes cut. There's no having to wait for them to kind of settle to the shape of the foot. So that was a real good buy. And at that point, I changed these over to my daily shoes because the way the arches inside there were, I needed that out of my daily shoe to help correct my feet because I have bad arches. The Keen are almost the exact same arch pattern. So wearing these helped my feet for when I was hiking and putting my Keens on. Now, when I say everyday shoe, I mean everyday. I mean, you can see these, they're covered with grass. I'm out mowing in them today. They are the Vibram soles, and they do grab. And if you look at the bottom, I mean, that right there is awesome considering 500 to 600 miles of hiking. And then you turn around and wear them daily for like the next, I don't know, 3 months. And daily, I mean, I work outside for a living, all right? Whether I'm down in the woods doing firewood, whether I'm here on the farm doing something, whether I'm on job sites, whether I'm out doing demolition. I mean, I'm in the worst of it. And the heels, spotting a lot of shoes that get wore off. These break off. The toes, toe guards are still solid. Let's check the other one. Toe guards are solid. Backs are solid. Now, I'm going to put something to you because even my wife's Keens have started to show wear here. If you want to check a shoe and see how tough it's built, check the back right here. If after about 400 or 500 miles this wears out, or even 200 or 300 in some shoes, you're in trouble. That's poor quality. Those are not even close to being worn out. They still have their padding. It hasn't been rubbed. You see what I mean? Look at the sides. Everything is solid. There's no holes worn through here or here. You know, the soles are still on and connected solid on both shoes. No holes. No holes. Everything's solid. Okay, it's just barely right here. Let's see if we can get that on there. See that little bit right there? But I can't make it bigger when I pull, so it's not coming unglued. It's just cut. Now, honestly, I would guess that I'm close to at least 800 miles on these, but they're not hiking miles because I've been wearing them every day for like work and around the house. And like when I come off trail, I'll pull my Keens off and loosen the strings on these. That's another thing. These are the original strings. All right. I have not changed them. These shoes cost $120 brand new at REI. I honestly could walk into REI right now with these if there was something wrong with them and they'd replace them. Because I'm like, I don't know, 20 days from my 1 year. But I'm not going to. These shoes have been well worth their money. There's nothing wrong with them. There's nothing I can complain about to even think about returning them. And I'll still probably get another 6 months just of wear out of them. Normal day-to-day wear and tear, you know. Use them around the house. Use them out doing firewood, things like that. Because of the Vibram soles, I've actually started wearing them when I run my chainsaw, which I know probably is not the safest thing, but they really do grab when I'm standing on logs well. And, you know, me being able to stand with a bum knee and a bum ankle is paramount. Now, they are not waterproof, but I've many times been up to here in water and they don't get wet. Okay, there is one downfall. One thing I don't like about these shoes, and only one. And I'll show you here. This one's the bad one. Okay, you see this leather right here? The strip of leather between this breathability fabric and this fabric and the toe bind. If you look real close, it's kind of cupped. When this gets wet and dries back out, it cups and then it pushes down on your toe. So what I end up having to do is either shove a baseball in there to stretch this after it gets wet, and then I'll get it wet again, or just something in there to hold this up and leave it in there overnight, and then this kind of works itself out. This one's not as bad about it, but if you look at the two, notice how one's thicker, that one's thicker, and that one's thinner. This one has just started to kind of roll up. The edges are rolled up. It's the same width material on both of them, just this one started to roll up. I don't know why. I'm sure it's just some random thing, or it may be something to do with, you know, how the toe sits, but I don't know. I could probably put some leather softener on there and work it out, and that'd fix it. But that was my only thing. But I mean, take you a good look at that. Ain't no soles popping. Ain't nothing falling apart. A lot of people talk about trail runners and how light they are and stuff. And I agree. I think they're amazing. But if you can handle the extra little bit of weight, I'm talking ounces here, difference between these and trail runners. Any good trail runner is going to get you at least 500 miles. You might get 1,000 out of them if you're lucky. And, you know, new brands come out every day, so that could change. Here soon, you know, they may have trail runners that are going to last you insane amounts of miles. But these, I feel like, as long as you're changing those insoles, you're probably going to get close to about 5 to 1,000 miles out of these easily. I have no doubts, because I know I had 5 or 600 when I stopped using these for hiking. And I still have, even on top of that, out on some like short day hikes, couple milers, you know. I don't bother changing my shoes for something like that. But everyday walking in these. And I mean, we're probably close, I don't know, 800, 1,000 probably miles on it. They're not even wore off. Not even close. For the money, I can't complain about them. And if you go into it, because Merrell's real good about covering their warranties on their stuff. Actually, I believe a friend of mine just had to return a pair, and she emailed and played with them, and then they just said, cut them, and we'll send you a voucher. And that's right. They make you cut them and send them a picture that you cut them. So there's no trying to scam them. That's not going to work. But I could call them and say, hey, look, these failed. And they would take care of me. So based on that, there's a shoe company. It's not a company. It's a company that's a store that sells shoes. It's a very under-the-radar company. It is a brick-and-mortar store. And availability is based on whatever store has what shoe. But they do carry Merrells a lot of times. It's called Shoe Department Encore. And I have seen these exact pairs in there. Remember, I said I paid $120 at REI for these. I actually saw these in there in a wide in my size, and I don't know why I didn't buy them, for $80. It was $79.99. So you'd probably come out the door with like $85, $90. That's $30 cheaper, you know what I mean? But generally speaking, the Merrell Moabs are almost bulletproof. I'm not going to say they are. All shoes have their failures. But these have treated me quite well. They really have. These are the wides, by the way. I mean, they are. And they are an 11.5. So, generally, I was wearing an 11. That's another reason kind of why I went to the Keens. Because as I've hiked more and more and more, your feet kind of smush out and widen, and you have to keep getting bigger sizes. That's another reason, because after my feet start to swell, they kind of push the edges of these. But there's no complaints. I have no complaints for the $120 I spent on these. I spend more than that on a regular pair of sneakers, and they don't last the year. You know, and that's just using them part-time. So when you can buy a good set of hiking shoes, take them out, abuse the crap out of them in the worst of places. Another thing is I've never washed these. I've never put these in the washing machine. And I've had these things caked to the top with mud. You just leave them outside, let them get rained on. I do use Rocket Pure's foot spray for inside to make sure they don't stink or nothing. But other than that, I don't really do anything to these shoes. I've just absolutely abused them. The toe kicks are solid. The rear heels are solid. The soles are solid. So if you want to invest in a good pair of shoes that you can feel comfortable really abusing out on the trail, and you can put on, and generally speaking, I'm speaking only of the Moabs, because Merrell does make other lines that aren't, you know, pull them on and go. The other ones do have to have break-in period. But for me, the Merrell Moab 2s, you pull them on, you go. You don't have to have any break-in time. And that's me going doing 22.5 miles the first day I bought them. You know what I mean? I bought them and then, like, literally got up and we went. So I would recommend them. I'm going to get another pair. I will not get the waterproof, though. I'll probably go ahead and get the mid-top waterproofs and run them, and I'll let you guys know how they do, but I'm sure they'll function just as well as these did. So, till next time, I'm Tony, and find the gear that works best for you and just enjoy it.